1 year ago, Sarah Ferguson, the Duchess of York, found herself mired in a notorious pay-for-access scandal involving her ex-husband, Prince Andrew, and an undercover sting operation. She hit a desperate low, but has embarked on an emotional journey to help rebuild her life and find out why she made certain choices.
Why? Well, that's good.
That was good, and that was a clip from her televised journey, but she reveals even more details of her personal struggle in her new book, Finding Sarah, A Duchess's Journey to Find Herself. And she joins us live on the Curvy Couch, as she has many, many times.
Thank you very much. Nice to see you again.
You've had quite a year, haven't you?
I have indeed. I have indeed. But, you know, in that auto cue when you say pay for access, actually, thank you for saying that, because that's not true. I did not sell access to my ex.
So what was it? What were we seeing in that sting
video? What you're
seeing
is a woman, very, very, really low and exhausted, yes, glasses of wine, and you saw her being trapped by a person who was sent to me by a girl who was 15 years my friend. Mm. And she said, go and see my father's best friend who wants to invest in your charity work and in what you in your business.
So when you were money, you thought it was an investment?
No, I didn't. Alison, it wasn't like that, OK? It was, he was going to invest in my business. And so he said, oh, by the way, this is for your friend. Take the 40,000 for your friend. Right. And I went, oh, okay. I didn't even think about it because I wasn't thinking. Mm. And that was the, I take full responsibility for my actions of simply not thinking. And what was I thinking? How can you take dollars in Britain? Hello, wire it if you want to help. Mm. And I just didn't think. And that's the problem, is that you know, because of your lapses of judgment and, you know, good judgment comes from bad judgment.
Well, and after that was publicized, and you know, it's good to hear your side of the story, you realize that I got to do something.
Well, yeah, I went to Oprah, and you know, Oprah became my friend.
As we all do. We're, yes, we're in trouble, we go to Oprah.
Yeah. Right. Well, I got Stedman.
You do? You got what?
Nothing. Stedman. Stedman.
Yeah. I love Stedman.
He's a good guy.
He's a great
guy. He's been by before, but Oprah doesn't return our calls.
Yeah. Oh, really? Oh, okay.
But that's a nice story.
Okay.
Yeah.
Stedman's great. Anyway, so I went to Oprah, and I said, Oprah, you know, I need help. And so she sent me privately to Martha Beck in Arizona, where I work with the horses. And then I...
And Dr. Phil.
And then I went to Dr. Phil.
I mean, her whole stable of self-help gurus. And so what have you, now that you've been through the paces, I mean, what have you learned from all of them?
Oh, so much. I mean, the fact is I've learned to find Sarah in a way that I can sit here and say, no, that's not true. Whereas before I'd go, oh, okay. You know, I was very much an addict to approval and acceptance, as Dr. Phil says. Mm-hmm. Dr. Phil says, Sarah, you're an addict. And I go, yeah.
Right. And then he tosses to commercial.
Yeah. And I and then I say, to Dr. Phil, I'm really pleased you said I'm an addict. At least you've labeled some of my behavior and sabotage and low self-esteem as that. Anyway, so what he, it's really good because he goes, Sarah, you're going to be on the bleachers, or you're going to be on the middle of the football ground and, or soccer.
So, right. No, we say both.
Okay. All right. And so I said, no, I want to be in the middle and I want to carry on doing my charity work and I want to get back, you know, my self-esteem. I lost it, threw it away. And Suze Orman said to me, which was really good as well, she said, Sarah, you don't have a financial problem. You have such bad self-esteem that you make the wrong decisions from
that leads to financial problems.
It leads to that guy falling in that trap.